bought a Glock 40 with dirty, dug it off at Granny Crib. I used to always tell my mama drop me off at Granny Crib. If I ain't posted at the store, I'm probably at my Granny Crib. So I done had some good times chilling at my Granny Crib. My first time smoking on some reefer, I was in my granny backyard. Beat a nigga up in her driveway. Nigga from the hood was trying to act.
So you know we went to the site, we had drive to it.
Yeah.
Soon as right there saw the Atlanta sign. He said, hey, that's ludicrous.
What's up, Kobe?
Well, great, I just hope this happens. So, every time we move, fuck out of this shit. Talk
about it. Dang. How
you week? It's been a good one. It's been a long one.
Been a good long one.
Yeah. How your week been?
Long. I've been goddamn days. I've been thinking if it's Wednesday, it's like, I'll be thinking it's Thursday or Friday. Wednesday was long as fuck.
Your days running in together. My boy scored 25. They was down 18. No, they was down 22-7.
22-7.
It was like, that nigga looked at me, fool. He was mad for it. I said, calm down, just have fun.
Have fun.
I'm trying to be a good dad. This shit really in my head. I'm like, you fool, got me. That nigga looked at me for, I just, man, have fun, calm, relax, calm down, because he was getting mad. The man, he was like Super Saiyan. The nigga had 5 seals in a row.
Go cool.
5 seals in a row. That nigga cold, fool.
That nigga young, that nigga cold.
Hold on, we gotta say, hold on, fool. Hold on. Nigga, one steal, he stole it, boom. Tiptoed the baseline, stepped through two. Stepped through, finger roll. And it was like, I saw that moment. I gotta give me some more money. I gotta invest this. I saw that then.
Oh shit.
That nigga gonna be some shit. That nigga gonna be some shit.
Where you get it from?
I think it was me. He got that dog in for me. He might have got the hooping skill like from my mama though.
From your mama?
Yeah. You know my mama wanted to be regular. Scholarship shit. Yeah, 32, okay. Yeah. Uh-huh. Dolly and Smith, look it up. They still got my picture up at UAPB in the gym.
Right now. What do old players, like, you know, back in her day, say about her? I know what they say about my mom.
I don't know.
You don't know? You never asked?
I ain't never asked. Uh-huh. But I know, but like these just because, like, stories just be coming up. Yeah. Bulldog was hard. All they talk about how she used to shoot.
Mm-hmm.
She's a shooter.
She a shooter.
Curry before Curry. She could be Reggie Miller's sister, Cheryl Miller. My mama can beat Cheryl Miller, fool. My mama can beat Cheryl Miller, fool.
Cap.
Right. Where the 100 points at?
Where the 100 points at?
Yeah.
Oh, is we gonna challenge what change the 100 points to?
I am. I wanna see it. I wanna see it.
Yeah. Hey, but I thought my granddad could outshoot Jordan.
Hell no.
Man, my granddad, bro.
Hey, take a shot.
You don't think my granddad can outshoot Jordan?
Hell no.
Man. Hey, one thing like about my mom, they say about my mom though.
Yeah.
Either she gonna block the shot, hey, or she gonna fuck.
Yo, let's talk about like. Let them get to know you, fool. Me? How was your week?
How my week?
Yeah, like your week.
Oh, we've been good.
What happened?
What happened?
Yeah. What happened this week?
Man. Bruh. I need to save some fucking money.
Real nigga shit.
Real nigga shit.
Real nigga shit.
Man.
Damn. You drank it to that.
Yeah. Felt good.
How was y'all week? Who gonna go first? Zaboomba Foo, AB Foo. Who gonna go?
What?
Who gonna go? Yeah, awkward.
My week was pretty cool.
Hold on, Bree says she's talking on camera no more. Bree, you ain't talking on camera while the camera on the court no more. She's standing on it. You ain't talking. Oh. Hey, that's the only bad comment we ever had.
What?
About Bree?
About Bree? We had a bad comment.
What's that say?
Who the fuck is that talking? She needs to shut the fuck up.
I don't call it out like that. You know, I call out people like that.
That shit fucked up. Damn. These me and Granny Crib. Fuck them folks, Brie. Fuck them folks.
But damn, I was saying some real shit.
Oh, God.
He was.
He was just a peeing, man.
That nigga was just a hater.
Exactly. I ain't like my
voice.
Came from the outside.
Can't get in. Hello.
That was our first hater.
Yeah. Shout out to fucking Charleston. That nigga's a legend.
That man is funny, fool. That man ain't been on one for the last 2 weeks.
That nigga been on one since he started. That nigga go, goddamn. Oh God! Shit.
Pass me.
That was some ghetto shit that nigga did. That nigga, we need rules to life.
We need
some rules to this shit.
Ain't no rules to this.
Nah, it ain't no. That's the fucked up shit about it because everybody's saying that shit. But we need some rules to this shit. But we need them from the beginning. Damn. I guess they said I'm gonna get to talking to. They say shit. Nah, but we need some rules to this shit because a lot of shit we be going through, I feel like we shouldn't have to go through because life can be so simple. This shit could be so fucking simple.
It can.
This shit could be so fucking simple, but it's like, damn, folks coming up with like, God damn, fool, what the fuck is you doing? You know this dumb as fuck. That's not dumb to you.
That shit be stupid.
And it could be anything.
Very accurate.
I feel like running a red light is the dumbest shit in the world.
On which side?
When you running a red light.
Oh,
It's fun when you're doing it, but I feel like that's the dumbest shit in the world. That shit dumb.
That
I was watching that shit yesterday. I was watching that shit yesterday. I was watching nigga, we right here on Winchester. Right there on Winchester, goddamn, right before we go to 240. We right there. This nigga just running like, knowing when you make this left turn, it's a double lane. Yeah. I'm like, bro, that was dumb as fuck.
Yeah.
Like, why?
You don't see that.
And then the dumb shit about it, he didn't keep going. The nigga just sat there. like dumb shit like that pisses me off. Yeah. Like that, Memphis niggas. Damn, I fuck with y'all, nigga. But damn.
Damn.
That nigga stupid as fuck. They think that. No, they say Memphis is, damn, I screenshotted this hoe. Nah, hell no. This shit got down.
It's factual.
Shit, they did scientific studies on this shit. So they say. So boom, top five most stressed cities in America. Cleveland, Ohio, Detroit, Michigan, Baltimore, Maryland, Memphis, Tennessee, Gulfport, Mississippi.
I'm so stressed out with these motherfuckers. I'm stressed out with these folks, fool.
Like, shit. And I believe that shit. Memphis people mean it for. Mm-hmm. Memphis people ruled it a motherfucker.
I will be gone in a year.
They funny as fuck, fool. Memphis funny as fuck, bro.
Memphis niggas
funny as fuck. And you know what we need in Memphis for real? Besides the police, bro. We need a bunch of people to just start beating up these motherfuckers that's still not cars. They're still in cars. We need to beat their ass. Everybody just need to start beating their ass.
You talking about like on some black activist side?
Yeah.
Like come together as a community.
Yeah, come together.
Neighborhood watch actually doing something.
Yeah, bro.
I'm with
you. Man, I'm tired of these cars.
I'm with you. Because they're like, they tried to break in my house, in the car.
Yeah.
I was like, shit, man, nigga. I wanted one of them niggas. I wanted one of them. I rolled around the block 3 times, knowing I wasn't gonna see nobody.
One time they broke in my Benz. I was at Barlow's, and I was talking to my partner, whatever. He said, "Bro, we need to set the car back right there, and motherfucking wait on the other side, hide out on the other side, wait for a motherfucker to try to break in that bitch again."
He don't want to touch somebody.
Tired of that shit,
bro. That's like the show they got when they be leaving the doors open. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm talking about? Like when they be leaving the doors open and shit. It's a show like they got a show like that.
Damn.
Real deal. Damn, what's the name of that shit?
Bait
car. Bait. There's some shit like that. They'll leave your money in like the glove console and all that shit. Hell yeah.
Man. Then they don't care. They doing it broad daylight. They did it in my job.
For real?
Yeah, bro, they like, it was like, oh, they came in through the exit gate, went in there, like, took a picture of the main stuff, and then they had left, but then they came back, because nowadays you can take a picture, they tagged to see whether they got the kill switch or some shit like that on it.
Yeah.
So they came back, went into that nigga shit, broad daylight. Could, and then I guess he got nervous because we pulled up top flight security.
Hey, y'all showed for that. You see, I stopped myself because I was showing for that. So, what you do?
I called police. And the police made me so fucking mad, asking me all these irrelevant questions like, hurry up and get here, nigga, and get these folks. I guess the young nigga was mad because So you know what I'm saying? I'm on the phone with them. She asked me all irrelevant ass questions. What they got on? Niggas, fuck all that. Just hurry up and get here.
Help me.
Fool. And then, like, he got nervous, so he tried to come through the side. Couldn't through the side. Then he went through the sunroof or whatever. Man, got through that giant. The other female officer, she recording this shit. I'm caught. He couldn't crank it up, I guess. And so he leave with
it. Hey, boy, you funny as fuck.
Man,
you know?
Man, that shit pissed me off, fool. That shit pissed me off, fool. And then, so me and the girl, like, we up there, everybody out there, the police out there and shit. I said, hey, don't laugh, fool, when I say this shit. We looking like Craig and Dana, y'all. Yeah, we looking like Craig and Dana out here, fool.
So you was mad that you had to look like that?
Man, yeah, cause the first thing nigga gonna say,
where's security? Where's security? Where's security? You know you're a snitch, right?
Huh?
You know you're a snitch.
I am, fool. I came to terms with that shit. Out of all security jobs I done had, fam.
You police in full right now.
All security jobs I done had, bro. I'm fucking.
You doing your job. Like, this ain't no easy assignment.
None.
This ain't no easy assignment.
None. This is dangerous hell, bro.
Oh, man.
Especially at the mall. City girl, they hit the black stones.
Man, city girl, fuck that. We gotta take a shot for DC.
DC?
Yeah, yeah. Said that Kia switch shit and I thought about that. Give me a shot.
DC.
Take a shot for my nigga, man. Hey, get well soon, my boy.
Yeah.
I'm so open to ask you, did that nigga need anything? Nah, you straight. You straight?
Yeah.
You taking what? Granny baby. Real shit. Man.
Hell nah,
we need some
looking in this motherfucker.
This one for that boy DC, man. Get well soon, my boy.
Yeah, shit.
Damn, girl! Who the fuck gonna be a backup now? Yeah. Little fuck.
God damn.
Oh, man.
Hey.
Type shit. Take another one, man. For my nigga, man.
Damn, we just put
I don't give
down.
A fuck. I don't give a fuck. Shit.
I'm
gonna
take the rest of mine.
I gotta stop drinking. That's how my week been. That's how my week been.
Yeah.
That's how my week been.
Bruh. I think that's one of the most stressful things about me. I don't really go visit people in the hospital.
It's hard as fuck, bro. That's some tough shit. That's some tough shit. Especially when you know how a motherfucker is.
Man,
real shit.
You know the shit a motherfucker will be talking.
Yeah, yeah.
You know the jokes if it was dog. If the shoe was on the other foot.
I was just about to say that.
If the shoe was on the other foot.
Man. Type get the shit, fuck man. Up.
Yeah.
Get the fuck up.
Yeah. Like, fool. Like, that shit broke me down. Like, nigga. That nigga know I talk shit. That nigga know I don't like a nigga to give me his left hand to shake.
Damn.
He know that. Nigga know that shit. I did that shit. Like,
you
know,
lights flipping and shit.
Nigga.
Cause he
said
taking another shot.
Yeah, cause he's cool. He gonna be fine.
I know. That nigga coming back strong. Yeah, you know he gonna come back louder.
Yeah,
that was it.
Hey, being a nigga, nigga impressed me. I had to call you and say, damn, that nigga, they say it on top of that ass. You know, I like to see a nigga fresh.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, shit. Like to see a nigga fresh as a motherfucker. That nigga was fresh as hell.
That nigga was fresh as fuck on his birthday. Green juice, banana, and spinach. Like highway patrol, bitch, I'm chasing these tickets. Had a dream about the Benz, woke up and cop. The exhaust on that shit, woke up the block. I don't got too much time, I be working a lot. I got baby in the... I top five dead alive, my nigga fresh as fuck. Hey, he in the top three.
He up there.
Nigga, we went to see Larry June, who my nigga had a hem in his fucking shirt. That bitch was wham, like layers on layers. Then he had the G-Shock. I'm gonna say that bitch was orange. This nigga was fresh as fuck.
That nigga was fresh as fuck,
damn.
My nigga be fresh as hell. Put that shit on.
This nigga fresh.
And he gonna let you know.
When y'all went to Atlanta, fresh as fuck.
Hey,
okay.
That nigga be fresh. Hell yeah. Nigga gonna still be fresh on y'all ass, man.
Definitely is.
Coming back hard. Coming back strong. He was already hard. He really gave niggas a break.
He gave niggas a break.
No. This is what he doing. Nigga say, hey, y'all catch up right now.
Catch up right now.
Pass, y'all. Give me y'all time to do what the fuck y'all gotta do. I'm talking to y'all, Will. Because I'm just talking like DC. He give me y'all time to do what the fuck y'all gotta do.
Oh, you set wearing ass nigga?
Oh my God. He hates y'all, bitch.
He don't like that?
Hell no.
I hate a nigga wear a set, fool.
I don't like sex.
I hate a nigga wear a set, fool.
Some sex be hard. Some sex be hard, but it just, yeah, you know. We hate that shit.
Man, I remember the day I
shout that out too.
What?
Cause that shit, that set that I got from him was so quality. Like, I think I got that 2 years ago, and I still have it. Like, I hang it up.
You can wash that shit 10 times.
It's embroidery, like. So,
yeah, bro got good quality on
this
shit. All his shit, he got good quality.
And nigga, we ain't just saying that though.
Nah, for real.
This shit,
they asking about your shit at the warehouse.
Real shit.
They asked me about it in Atlanta.
I wore that blue shirt, the blue with the embroidery on the back.
Uh-huh. Who shit that is? That's a hard fool.
That's a hard fool. Fool.
Who the fuck called me off?
Really tried to get off.
Really?
You really tried to get off. Cause who the fuck called me on? We gonna let that one go.
Hey, you remember I called you? I said, for my, I was talking about my birthday.
Hold on, I said, go off for
my birthday.
You got me fucked up. You got me fucked up.
How about that aunt shit?
Yeah, then she gonna say you is up there.
Cause they call me auntie sometimes.
You look like your mama, boo.
All right, not too much.
Damn, not too much. You get what I'm saying?
I know now.
You get what I'm saying?
I love younger than you.
You coming though?
You say what?
You are coming.
He's been drinking his water. I've been drinking little.
You are coming up there though. But
I'm stressed.
But we don't look as old as our parents and shit though.
Damn,
bitch.
Damn,
old as fuck.
Do I look old?
Huh?
I look old.
You look of age. You look like you 30 something, bro. But you look like a young, like.
I'm fine with that.
You know
this
what I'm
shroom got to get out of me.
Because
I've been wanting to cry all fucking day.
No, you didn't let it out.
Nah, hell nah.
It'll cut it out. Cut it out.
I can't. That shit's just gonna come. It ain't coming right now.
Come.
You need Dr. Phil.
What?
Y'all, yeah, it's a show on Netflix. You know the girl that was like, "Catch me outside." How about that?
Yeah.
She was saying Dr. Phil and them had made her do that shit. It was her, and there was a whole bunch of other folks too. I don't know. That's something I have to watch.
That shit believable.
I don't know who she is.
I know y'all saw the Nickelodeon shit though.
Oh, man.
Yeah, that shit was
when
crazy.
They was like, they was
I saw clips, I didn't watch it through.
I mean, I watched that whole shit. That shit was crazy. It was just like,
they was molesting kids. On
that shit. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That nigga
he's still not locked up.
That nigga ain't locked up.
No.
So the first guy, I don't know what his name was, but he got locked up, and then like he registered as a sex offender, but he still works in Hollywood. But the other one didn't.
That man ain't need to be locked up.
Why don't you get locked up for that? Because they be knowing information
on motherfuckers, so they be trying to keep people like hidden and shit.
You gonna be counseled? We gonna get counseled.
Man, come on. Oh, we working on. Ain't it, bro? Cause, when I finally watched that Jeffrey, had fucking folks like, goddamn, the president coming to his island.
Your president went there. You probably with that too?
Nah, Obama, fool. We ain't doing that one.
Okay,
we ain't putting that one out there.
He did what he did while he was the president. So they're trying to say he just made the best decision for the country for the president. Bullshit. Think about this though. A nigga can run out country that's a felon.
But
a nigga can't vote for the felon.
Hey, nigga,
we need one of them stores. We need one of them stores.
Sprunin was bad as fuck.
Bad as fuck.
Hey, that nigga worse than his hell. Bruh.
I bet Sprunin one of the most athletic niggas you know, though.
Sprunin one of the most athletic niggas I know. Cause he was spinning carriage with Travis. Mm-hmm. And that nigga Sprunin all running that hoe. Yeah. I'm glad the man out.
Free that nigga Sprunin. Sprunin free. Shit, nigga, we can finally say that shit about.
Yeah.
Sprunin free.
Hey, after that shit though, after that nigga Trump got through this shit right here, and still can run for president, man, free every fucking thug that's out there.
Free
Vibes
Cartel.
Free who?
Vibes Cartel.
Vibes Cartel?
Yeah.
Who's Vibes Cartel?
A Jamaican artist.
Mm-hmm. Who that is?
Y'all know who that is?
Man, bring my nigga Shaq to the Shaq free, cause free got Shaq. Down. Cause Shaq got down. Yee yee. Just like that. Just like that. Yeah, man. Like, free that nigga Shaq, man.
Damn, he's talking
about. Let me take this off.
Okay. It circulates through your brain.
Bro. Man, that shit is beyond me.
What's
beyond? But you think y'all think he gonna get the immigrant votes?
Huh? Who?
Cause they still thought about that ICE shit.
Hey,
you think they gonna get the immigrant votes?
Hey, so what's a black job?
A black job.
The White House.
Like controversial, like he keeping his name popping like that because try. I'ma sound like I really fuck with this nigga. I just feel like that nigga know how to say shit. He know black people that's VPs or president, like, you know what I'm saying, CEOs and all type. You feel me? He know people like that.
Yeah, he know how to get the masses worked up.
Like, he does, you feel me?
That nigga
like,
know how to seduce the masses. That nigga had to read the book. He had to read the book.
This is what happened, everybody's favorite cousin, man. This is what we need y'all to do, man. We need you to like, share, subscribe. Do everything you can to get us there for grandma, you feel me?
Hey, man, fuck this shit. Just hit the fucking button.
Hello,
fuck what they talking about. Like, comment, subscribe. We're gonna repeat this shit every fucking episode for the motherfuckers in the back. Motherfuckers at Auntie Crib, I don't give a fuck. Arnez house that can't fucking talk. Hey man, press the motherfucking like.
Do it
for your grandma, man.
If you got a grandma, I'm gonna hit like, share, subscribe.
God damn it.
Tell a friend.
Fuck what you talking about.
Do it for my grandma.
Fuck what you talking about.
Do it for my grandma. Like, share, subscribe.
And Auntie, what's her name?
Angel.
Hey, Robert Green, a motherfucker. I would like to introduce Robert Green. I'll interview Robert Green.
I would, bro. I would too. As a nigga, most definitely.
Robert Green funnier than a motherfucker.
My name fool.
That nigga.
Hell yeah. That nigga Trump. That's a nigga that's manipulating the world, bro.
Who, Trump?
Hell yeah.
I honestly feel like that, yes. And it's just like, he just playing into every, like, he just playing into what's like, it's hard to explain.
And the only nigga,
it's hard to explain to me because he doing it so fucking well.
Yeah, he doing it great. He doing
so,
the job.
So anything I say.
He
you say what?
He had all this shit
playing
there.
Like, he, like, this some motherfucking, like, nigga, this some, I told you this shit was gonna happen type shit. Like,
really?
Like, yeah,
that's why I'm asking, is he gonna get the immigrant votes? Because, hey, they still know what he did now. The ICE shit. When they was, when he was locking up all the immigrants and sending them back to their country.
Okay.
Shit.
That was.
They can't even vote, though.
But.
That was down in Florida, coastal Florida, and all that shit, right?
Florida, Texas. Hey, shit. New York. All type of shit. ICE is on their ass.
I don't remember.
Chicago. ICE is on their ass, fam. And that was like taking, like, So that was taking jobs away for shit like niggas ain't doing.
What niggas ain't doing?
Bruh, niggas ain't getting them motherfucking Orangersfield and goddamn Cali. Niggas ain't doing that job. That's a job a nigga ain't doing.
Okay. Okay. So is that black jobs? Is that considered a black job?
Not no more.
So that's their job. That's why he really tried to put us back in the field.
Dang, we ain't doing this shit, fool.
So Project 2025.
I just looked that shit up today. I don't really fully understand it, but like,
hey, wait.
I looked it up a little bit. I was looking it up on our way here, like, mm-hmm. Project 25, like.
What caught my eye, it was like, the no fault divorce, like that would be abolished.
Until you been through a divorce, my nigga. Look at Shumper.
You been through a divorce?
Yeah.
Talk about it. I've been through a divorce.
Yeah, I've been through a divorce.
How messy that whole guy?
Huh?
I messy that whole guy?
Man, for like 3 years straight, she talked about some.
3 years you was going through that motherfucker. That's a long time.
No. Well, I didn't file for it because she was talking about that, what's that shit? Alimony shit? Alimony. Bitch, where's the alimony? What the fuck? I was doing different than before. That's fucked up. But what was I? But what I was doing different before we got married? I was cheating before we got married. I got cheating when we got married. Like,
oh shit,
bro. Fuck. Alimony, bro. Come on, fool. I 3 years talking about this shit. Then I finally talked to her about it, and we kind of like, it's time to move on, type shit.
Yeah.
We ain't had shit together. So,
did you like her?
Did I like her?
Hey, folks, you finna get out these papers.
Huh? Oh, yeah. About to get out the papers. About to get back to blowing on this. Boom, about to be saying, hey, smoking all that weed, dog.
Yeah. Oh, man. Oh! Damn, fool. We be manifesting like a motherfucker.
Yeah.
Mama ain't got no job no more. Mama retired.
She retired?
She done retired. Mm-hmm. She ready to blow it down.
She ready to blow it down.
We walking this shit down. Ooh, this shit ain't coming how we want it to come, but this shit just fucking. Hey, life. Life be life.
Yeah, it do.
But listen, though.
We gotta do our part.
Life's good.
Life is good. We gotta do our part more.
What the fuck are you talking about?
We gotta stop putting ourselves in compromising positions.
I get you.
But shit happens.
Shit happens.
Shit fucking happens.
Shit happens, bro. What's a compromising position, man? What?
Man, when I got the DUI, and I was trying to get my arm security license, and they said because I got the DUI, I can't get my arm security license.
Mm-hmm.
Now I gotta go figure out something else.
Yeah.
Shit like that.
But you didn't even, wasn't even thinking about no, this gonna affect that.
Hey.
Stupid ass shit. Like, yeah. Niggas just be in the moment. That moment of motherfucker. It's hard not to be in the moment when you in the moment though.
Yeah.
That's some high shit right there. That's some high shit right there. It's hard to be, not be in the moment when you in the moment.
Mm. But we gotta live in the moment.
See you higher. Yeah. I'm living that motherfucker.
Yeah.
It's your life. It's your life.
Definitely yours.
Hmm.
But we be in too many. Damn.
So boom. Okay. So boom. A better me. So shit. Just that long air question. But it's just me and you right now, so I feel like, shit, whoa. So shit, if you could change something about your life, what would you change? Like, what would be a difference? What's something you would have done different?
Staying. Like, I sit into my shit. Like, I feel like, pivotal moment in my life was, cause I be seeing it. Like when I leave, I do so much fucking better.
Yeah.
But then when I stay, it's like I'm just it's
stagnant.
Yeah. Cause I feel like, bro, I feel like in 10th grade, I should have never came back to Hernando. I should have moved to cause I had. In the summer of ninth grade, whatever, I moved to South Haven. Then my guardian died. I walked in on her dead on the couch. I think she died of a stroke.
Yeah.
Heart attack or something. And I had a chance to move to Ohio. shit like that.
You should have went to Ohio.
I feel like I would have a whole different.
Why you stay though?
Probably shit. It's just something about being home.
You wanna know crazy? Them niggas in the military used to always say, when you get out, don't go back home.
And we go back home.
And niggas go back home. You get comfortable as fuck. Yeah. They always, every nigga, yeah. Like, I know that, they always say, don't go back home. I get it, though.
Yeah.
I get it.
Yeah. Nigga, I feel like I would, if I would have moved to Ohio with my uncle, I feel like I could have got that guidance. And I could ask that nigga some shit that I need to know at the time.
Yeah. So, at that time?
Yeah.
You must can't call him and ask him.
Oh, I'm still there. He called me right now. So it's like certain questions like is taboo to ask. Like I don't want to be that older cousin that you can come to like scared to ask the taboo questions.
What's your name? What's a taboo question, bro?
Man, I got a cousin right now. She 16, finna get her own car right now and stuff. Shit finna be different. You know when you get the car, shit finna be different. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Man, okay, your dad can tell you this and that, but then
you need somebody to tell them,
and then somebody that's gonna bring you around it and like, yeah, see, this is how it goes down. Cause, yeah. Bro, that hurt my fucking feelings when motherfucking I tried to go to TSU and I couldn't get into TSU. Wow. And my uncle, like, I never been on a college campus.
Mm-hmm.
My uncle brought me to a college campus. That's TSU. Yeah. Super fucking live. I gotta be here. Yeah. 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 I mean, you know, broaden my horizon and shit.
Real shit. Did you remember when BET used to play the Southern Heritage Classic games and shit? Like, yeah. Alabama State University versus Grambling. And I went to one of them hoes. Well, we just talked about this shit. Like, nigga, I've been to one of them hoes in that atmosphere. Like, nigga, that shit's different. Like, that's black excellence. I like black fun.
Yeah.
Like we really having fun here. Ain't worried about shit.
Yeah. I wanted to go to University of Florida. If I couldn't get into University of Florida, I wanted to go to a HBCU.
Yeah.
And goddamn it, them hoes live. Ooh, them hoes live.
Shout out to University of Arkansas Pine Bluff.
I almost went there.
I almost went there.
But that's it. I think everybody should get their experience.
I only did a semester.
Had fun.
Had a ball. That's all I needed, though. I did one semester, had a ball. I did everything them niggas did.
Yeah.
It was 4 years strong. I did everything they did and goddamn left. Man, shit, that shit was great.
Yeah.
That shit different. Like, that shit different. Cause being at the University of Memphis, I'd be like, bro, you at PB ain't got that. You know what I'm saying? It's definitely a financial difference. Like, mm-hmm. You definitely tell the financial, but then again, the time frame too.
Yeah.
Nigga, I was there in 2012.
Different time. Way yeah, different time. It's
2024, now that's 12 years.
Yeah.
12 of them motherfuckers, nigga. We got MacBooks now. Nigga, they have MacBooks then. Nigga, it was real deal going to the library and motherfucking doing homework.
Yeah.
You feel me? It wasn't... This shit too easy now. Like, nigga, you see... Nigga, real shit. I can talk to you while I'm on campus. Just like, I'm walking to my next class. You know, whoa. You feel me?
Yeah.
We having a conversation and everything. Like, nigga, in 2012, nigga...
I can't have no motherfucking conversation
campus
about it ain't even the campus too crunk. It's just like a mind capacity. Like my mind is on like, nigga, I ain't worried about shit. I'm really just here for school. Hello, damn, right. Minutes ain't free to after 7 in college. 2012.
Man, shit.
2012 and 2024. Think about this shit. That's some motherfucking damn. We old.
Hey, you knew plenty. Hey, you know plenty of people that was going to school for the check.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah.
Going after the check.
Going after the check. They probably thought that about me. Oh my god. Oh shit. Damn! Hey, I need y'all to Google some shit. Nigga, we can Google the shit. Park Mall, Little Rock. Damn, what's that mall, Little Rock? Nigga, I drove to that hole with my refund check. Nigga, I bought the 2012 Air Maxes, the gray and red holes. The 2012 Air Maxes, the gray and green holes. Nigga, I had the hoodie to match. Oh my god. Nigga, I came back to West Memphis. I had the glasses. The glock, nigga, I'm gonna find the fucking picture. I had the lime green glasses, flip that hoe up.
Yeah.
You know, You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Flip the hoes up, nigga, had the 501 Levi's, starched hard as fuck. Fresh as a motherfucker. Posted in front of the Malibu. In front of, bro, that shit was funny. Hey, I blew that refund check.
Man, come on.
They probably think, and then got that, but the thing, what about the refund check? I made that hoe look good, though.
Yeah.
I made that refund check look good as fuck. Nigga, bought my few outfits. I was still working. I went back to my job, Popeyes. Told my manager, I'm like, hey, man, I'm only finna be here for a little bit. I done applied for the Army and everything. I leave April 23rd, 2012.
Yeah.
And I said, all right, cool, come back. That's why it's good to keep good relationship with people.
Yeah.
It's good to keep good relationship with people because you never know when you're gonna need them.
Put your 2-week nose in.
Put your 2-week nose in. Put that. You said that, nigga. Life, you motherfucking life. Put the 2-week notice in. Because hey, shit might happen in that 2 weeks.
Ain't it?
Shit might happen in that 2 weeks.
Hey, gotta go back to that motherfucker.
Pull that motherfucker back. Shit ain't going like I planned. Damn, shit happened. But damn, hit that nigga Aaron up like, bro, I need my job. He like, bet, nigga, that check, shit, it probably like $2,700. I spent like $400 on it.
He ain't buy no books.
What's the book? Nigga, no, I'm not going back. No. See, the thing is, I didn't get my check to the end because we were trying to figure this shit out. Like, no. My mom and daddy had actually took a payment plan. Shout out to my motherfucking mom and daddy because they had hope for me. Yeah. They took a payment plan out. You know how much it takes to take a payment plan out for somebody? Shout out to them. So they did that. So my dumb ass found out that. And they were like, are you still going to apply for this loan? Hey, I want that loan. I want that loan. Shit, yeah. Don't get that loan. Don't do that. Don't
get
that
loan.
It's not worth it. It's only going to get you some pair of jeans. What they wearing now? Beats of... Balabas, it's only gonna get you a couple pair of Balabas. Don't do it. So I got down. I did all that. Woo, came back. What the fuck is the point of this story?
Bro, you talking about the refund.
Okay, the refund. I'm about to fuck this shit.
Oh, shit.
That shit was like, that's a lot to this shit. Yeah. I'm gonna think about it though. Yeah, it is what it is. Fuck that shit. It wasn't worth it, fool.
It wasn't worth it.
The refund check ain't worth it. It ain't worth it. But it's fun, though.
You know, it ain't worth going to school unless...
You going for, like, a doctor.
Unless you want to fucking go. I didn't tell
you. Hey, I feel good as fuck. Fuck them. Y'all getting my thoughts right now. Let's play, fool. We just chilling right now. Hell yeah.
Bruh. It ain't fucking worth going to school unless you serious about this shit.
Yeah. You right.
I was telling my cousin, you know, do what you want to do. If you want to go to college, cool. But, like, don't go to college if you ain't ready and you want to be, like, for real about this shit. Because you really just going to get a debt, my nigga. That shit going to fuck your credit up. Don't fuck your credit. Fucking with school. Unless you took for real about that shit.
No, you find out so many secrets these folks got.
Yeah.
They fuck their credit up.
I got a cousin was in so much school debt. Cried, my nigga. Cause he was in so much school debt. But that nigga out of it now though.
Yeah, I know.
Oh God, I can eat.
Hey, oh God, I can eat. Don't say crystals though.
My crystals knock on my door, I'm going to jail tonight. Chris is knocking my door tonight, I'm going to jail.
Hey, bro, you know what him done had me in a chokehold?
What?
Man, Popeye's signature hot wings have a nigga in a chokehold.
Y'all niggas love Popeye's.
Bro, you have you had the signature hot
wings? Yeah.
Okay, man.
Just bust.
They ain't better than KFC Junks was back in the day, though.
The honey barbecue Junks. Them Junks legendary.
I hate that shit.
Them Junks right there just ain't there. They ain't there. But that signature hot five.
That cheap. Fake chicken on taste real. What's up? What y'all talking about eating?
Crowd, but
I'm gonna answer. Oh, I got some groceries now.
Really? Shit, you, when you went grocery shopping?
Shit. Today? Yes. I've been grocery shopping 3 days in a row, actually.
And still ain't cooked.
And still ain't cooked. And goddamn.
Real nigga shit.
Got my kids here. We chilling. Kids here, y'all. Nigga, daddy. I'm in daddy mode right now. We having fun. I love this shit. I like that shit. That shit cool.
Yeah.
Nigga love the kids. Nigga
definitely love the kids.
We having our ball.
Yeah.
That's why you see the shirt, fool. Hey, play with my kids. Yeah, like shit, bitch. It's about the kids.
I hate you, bro. Oh man.
But anywho, today was a good day. This how this week been. Long as fuck. Been a long fucking week. Damn, we forgot to plug the clock up. Me and Trill were talking about that shit the other day.
Right
here. Hell yeah. Cause we be wanting people to start. I want people to start seeing how long this shit actually be going on.
Yeah.
They might not pay no attention, but like somebody gonna pay. Like, damn, they clock on. Damn, they started this time.
Man.
Damn.
Yeah. I like when we get folks on here. They just when they get here, bro, they don't be wanting to stop talking. For it.
That's everybody.
Hey, that nigga, Cambo.
Woo. That's a talker to that nigga anyway.
Man, you gotta let that nigga talk.
Yeah, gotta let something talk.
Hey, and
he then, gonna get his point across.
Hey, then you want that nigga rap. That nigga want to rap. That nigga just want to talk.
Hey, then get one nigga. That nigga called me last week. Hear what he said?
What?
Fool, y'all shit hard as fuck. Y'all got me want to start my own podcast. He said, I don't need nobody coming on that bitch though. I just want to talk. He said, I got shit to say. Nigga, we know. That bitch, I don't need. He said, I don't want no guests. He said, it's just going to be me just talking how I feel. I said, bro, you can do that shit. Because that nigga just fucking talk.
He had 8 episodes and y'all would goddamn podcast.
Nigga, that's our long. That's the longest one, eh?
The longest one?
He got the longest one. Sosa.
Sosa, you got the longest one?
That nigga talk for days.
I think, or the comic books. I think it's Sosa.
It might be Sosa.
The comic books was a conversation.
Yeah. How you loved about that one, bro?
I loved it. Yeah. I loved it. I learned a lot of shit. Nigga, baby,
we got to be a fucking nerd on that.
Got to be some nerds. Got to ask some questions. I ain't no such thing as a dumb question, kids. You feel me?
Man.
We just got to have fun.
Bro. Hell yeah.
That shit, we went back.
Yeah.
We went back.
Hell yeah.
PBS
kids type shit.
Yeah. We went back. And we were just talking about today, like, nigga, we really the problem. We the reason our kids ain't got Zaboomba food right now. We got PBS 10 right now.
Bruh.
We are a subscribing motherfucker.
Bruh.
Like, we the problem.
Bruh. We got to get these folks back for reading books for. Hey, you know why women smarter than us? They feel like they smarter. They feel like they smarter than us right now.
Okay.
If you it's really a lot of women still reading books right now.
Yeah.
Because I ask women, like, what book you reading? What book you reading? They ready to reel off a book. Mm-hmm. They got it on their tongue, what book they reading right now. Ready to reel it off.
That shit different, though. It ain't even different. That shit just rare right now.
Yeah. But it's fundamental.
But it's fundamental as fuck. Niggas ain't doing the fundamentals right now. But like I told you, fool, like, nigga, when we start the year off, talking about 10-year book, I want 10 books in a year.
Yeah.
Nigga don't read one book this year. One.
You don't really read one?
I'm on two right now.
I'm on two right now. You beating a lot of people.
I know. I know, but that's sad as fuck. That's sad as fuck. That shit.
Yeah. I got three books I gotta finish that I haven't read. But it's some other books I wanna read too. Huh? It's some other books.
What are they?
I actually wanna read the man, that Robert Greene nigga. I gotta read that Art of Seduction, and I gotta read that that 48 Laws of Nature.
Not 48 Laws of Power,
but the Human Nature. It's a Human Nature
by Robert Greene.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Hell yeah.
Human Nature, son. They gonna think you a fuck nigga.
Man, bro, that's a fucking manipulating ass fucking book.
That's why I want to interview Robert Greene.
Yeah, If niggas want to be not shit niggas, they'll fucking read that.
Robert Greene.
They'll read that Robert Greene junk, nigga.
This finna be so many niggas mad too.
Man, if you want to be on some bitches,
real shit.
You'll read that Robert Greene.
If you want to be an ain't shit ass nigga and get away with it for the rest of your life,
nigga, Trump read it. Trump reading that whole thing. Because it's more than just for talking to women. It's about...
That shit's about the world.
Seducing the fucking world, bro. It's about seducing the world, man.
Life is bigger than relationships. That's why I don't want to talk about no fucking relationship. life is bigger than a fucking relationship, yeah. Fool.
Yeah,
I don't want to talk about no fucking relationship.
Man.
What?
Life is beautiful, bro.
She ain't say life.
What she say?
Love.
Love is beautiful. Love is beautiful.
That shit cool.
Love is beautiful.
That shit cool.
Love is beautiful.
That shit cool.
Man, you try to get off one more time. You heard me the first time.
What?
You heard me the first time, bro. Man. Love don't gotta be that hard, though. Love ain't hard, man. You think love hard?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I do
actually. Hell no. Why love gotta be
but
so
everything
hard?
Everything is hard.
Why love gotta be so hard?
Everything worth having is hard.
But it's easy to be a fuck nigga a lot.